one of my watches. Roadies and hosses that drove me crazy. I can't even pronounce nothing. Pass that for safety. Then I spent $400 on this. Just to be like, nigga, you ain't up on this.
She is electricity. You're lying next to the person you love. That makes sense, right? Here we go. I'll wait it out till you come round. Face the look up in the big city, everything looks so far.
Oh, there's Steve right now, pulling up. Ah, shit. Fuck.
You know how convenient it is to get a coffee stopper?
A what?
A coffee stopper.
What do you mean?
Like,
how convenient it is to get one?
I order hot coffee and they're like, you want that? I'm like, fuck no, I'm a beast.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so we're doing Sunday fun day the right way.
It ain't that fun.
It's not gonna be fun at all. We got the live stream set up. We're about to be set up. I might go uno, dos, fucking finish us. The Pocky Challenge. I don't know if you guys have seen it. I'm sure you've heard about it, but it's that really fucking hot chip. It literally comes with one chip in the bag.
$50
in the bike. Is that what it costs now?
Nah, it's inflation.
It was like one of those fucking the gummy bears. If you ever read the Amazon reviews on those sugar-free gummy bears, people wanted to buy them. So the price went up. These are $50 for one motherfucking bag. You know, serious when I got the fucking Zoms on. I haven't worn these in a while. So one chip, one bag, this thing. What's it say on the back? Do you dare to go to hell and bike? This chip is crazy hot and not for the faint of heart or stomach. I'm so fucked. Heat seekers may eat at their own risk. Not everyone will enjoy the extreme heat. Should we have gotten anything for this?
No.
I'm gonna chug almond milk. Hey, I have two Powerade Zeros.
You're closing a door and no one's watching.
You ready? Get in the thumbnail, bitch. Where we take that?
Yeah, please.
I feel like I should like clean my hands.
All right, we're about to do the challenge. We only got one, because like Steve said, the economy's tough, so we split it. Still gonna fuck my day up, but.
It's gonna be bad, it's gonna be bad. Heather, I don't think we're going out today. The shit ain't gonna be good.
Trigger.
I'll let you pick the chip of choice.
All right, all right, all right, all right, all right, all right.
Take one,
take two.
Which one do you want?
Does it matter?
I don't know.
I'll take this one. Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh my god, already, dude.
Don't drink anything.
Why?
Don't drink anything. Give us a question.
Fuck.
Give us a question. Let's go. Let's rattle them off.
Fantasy questions. I'm crying. I gotta throw up. Big money, big booty, bitches, man. That shit gonna be.
Yeah?
Dude,
bite. Oh my god. Dude, I think you about to throw up.
I got the hiccups, I think. I'm sorry, I can't answer anything.
It's really fucking hot, like in your throat.
Oh my god. Powell. Give me Marvin Jones. I don't lease, I just thought
I'll feast. I put a blue caprice.
This is so bad.
Nick's not doing well. I think he might die. Bring me in with some chicken wings and some collard greens. That shit will crack. Just crack me. Oh! It's fucking hot.
Oh, dog, I'm crying.
Dude, stop. It's getting worse.
How long does this last for?
It's getting really bad.
How long does it last for anyone who's done it? Ah! Dave, buckle up. Are you fucking? No. Don't play like that. Don't play, Chris.
You got fruit. I'm more spiritual than lyrical. I'm similar to Eli. Why? Cause I'm wearing black shades and I'm headed west with the world.
20 to 30 minutes, best value, George Kittle.
It ain't getting better at all.
No, dude, it's getting worse. I'm out of milk, fuck. I think that milk might have made it worse. Nothing left. I drank the whole thing. My life like Pablo. My stomach hurts.
Yeah, that's the problem. Not for the faint heart. Holy fuck.
Spoonful of mustard cures hiccups? I feel like that's fake fucking news. Drake's dead, Pusha T killed him. Big facts only.
What are you doing, peoples? Got a big old bowl of banana peppers. Ain't no one like banana peppers like I do. Ain't nada, nitta, nada.
It's early. Is it Tuesday? It's Tuesday. I haven't been vlogging much lately the last couple weeks because now that it's like the summer and it's football season, I'm in like, I feel like I'm in album mode. Like when rappers are in album mode and they're just in the studio all the time. I'm getting out five videos a week pretty much because I have a Monday video, a Wednesday video, a Friday video, my vlog Saturday, and then I've been doing live streams the last couple weeks on Sundays. So pretty much it's five pieces of content along with my marketing work. So I just haven't really gotten around to showing y'all what I've been doing. It's been really nice out, so I've been playing basketball basically every day. Well, before I go to the gym, I'll go to the courts in my town, shoot around for like 30 minutes, almost like a warm up. I'll go work out. I've just been enjoying the weather that we're getting. Been working outside as much as I can. I have a nice tan. You guys probably can't really see it. Actually, I'm really burnt right now, but this is like the tannest I'll ever get. I'll go out and work on my front lawn. I'll just set up a chair, take my laptop out, and I might do it without a shirt on. My neighbor probably think I'm such a dick, just sitting out here with his shirt off, tanning. Maybe they don't think that at all, and I just say that for no reason. What else we got going on? My taxes are due on Friday. When you work for yourself, you gotta estimate your revenue and your expenses for the following year, and then take your net income, and then do your taxes based off that, and you have to pay them quarterly throughout the year. So I paid them today through the IRS website. I feel like I probably fucked it up and didn't do it right. So I didn't submit any forms. Pretty sure I submitted the right form in the beginning of 2018, and then I just have to make the payments throughout. But this weekend, I got two parties I'm going to on Saturday. One in New Jersey, girl I'm friends with moved into a new apartment, so we're having a housewarming. And it's another girl's birthday in the city, so I'll be in Manhattan later. Following weekend, we got a brunch. Me and the bike group, me and my friends are doing brunch in New York at a restaurant called Agave. If you're ever doing brunch in New York, well, you actually have to get reservations like a month or two in advance. This place is the absolute fucking goat. They just keep coming with margarita pitchers of shit. It's like $35 all you could drink, and they keep the margs flowing. We're gonna be like blacked out by like 1:30. It's gonna be awful. My weekends are packed from starting this Saturday all the way through like mid-August. I really gotta be on my game throughout the weekdays. Where am I traveling? Going to Atlantic City at the end of June. Going to Florida at the end of July for my college roommate's wedding, which is, it's in a Disney resort. It's gonna be sick. So me and my college friends are flying out Thursday morning. It's gonna be a Thursday, Friday, Saturday, fly back Sunday. And then a week after that, I leave for Cancun. I'm going to Mexico with Steve and my friends from home, from Emerson. We're doing an all-inclusive resort in Cancun for like 4 days. It's gonna be amazing. I don't know how many fucking margaritas I'm gonna drink, but I'm actually a little nervous for that. And then I'm having the draft day weekend. The draft weekend, where I'm bringing out 9 subscribers to New York City. We got the Airbnb, it looks incredible. I don't remember if I showed you guys that or not, but I put it in one of my fantasy videos. It was dope. It's like $3,000 for the weekend, where it's like a penthouse in Hell's Kitchen. It's so good. And then September, I think I'm going to Vegas, actually. My friends who work at iHeartRadio have a concert out in Vegas, and they kind of hook me up if I go. I just got to pay for flights. So I think I'm going to Vegas in September. My virtual real estate company clients invited me to stay with them in Denver in October. Or like renting out a cabin or something. One of them lives out in Denver. He's gonna rent out a cabin.
and like his whole company is kind of go stay there, and they invited me because I'm kind of part of the fam. And that's kind of what you look for, or what you should look for in clients. It's something that I look for. I was never really looking for like one-off relationships with my clients. I was never looking for clients that just wanted like, oh, can you just run one Facebook ad for me? Or, oh, this is just like a 1 week or 1 month project. I always wanted something that was more long-term. Like, you know, you become part of the company when you're doing things like this. So it's cool that they invited me. I'm excited to go there. I haven't been to Denver since I was young. I went to visit my cousin who was working out there. I was so young, I remember I got a fake ID taken away. We went to a bar and I was under the age of 21. I got an ID taken away there, so I must have been like 18 or 19 at the time. So I haven't been there in 7 or 8 years. So I'm excited to get there. And that's really it. Otherwise, we're just chilling for the rest of the night. Still got some daylight. I might go back outside and hang out there. So going back to something I was talking about last vlog, or it might have been the one before that, about partnerships and figuring out what brand deals and partnerships you want to be looking for. I'm bringing it up because I just got an email from a company called Thrive Fantasy. Their marketing manager reached out to me. They said they are a new daily fantasy sports app catering to the everyday fan. We just fully launched at the end of March and the reception so far has been great. We're really looking forward to the upcoming NFL season and thought Big Dogs Fantasy would be a great partner to help us get the word out about Thrive. We'd be very interested in setting up a time to discuss more about a potential partnership. Please feel free to reach out. I know last time I talked about how a company reached out to me and I didn't really have any interest because I had never used the actual app or the website. I didn't get a good vibe from the original email that I got. And this seems more professional. He is the marketing manager for this company. It also came through a message through my website's messaging system. So that means that he took the time to, wherever he found me from, I'm not sure if he found me through YouTube. If he did, that means he took the time to go through my website and then messaged me through there, which tells me that he put in work on the back end, right, to actually make sure that he sees this as a good fit. So that's a good sign for me, number one. Now, the reason I'm bringing it up to you guys now, because I haven't looked into anything, so I figured I'd do this as like a play-by-play kind of process and see what I would do. So I have his name, I have his email, I have the company name. So the first thing I would do would just be to type in the company name on Google, see what I could find. So I typed in Thrive Fantasy. They're the first search result on Google. Tells me that they have some authority, that they are, you know, in fact, a popular website. Because every website or every person that reaches out to you, especially when they're starting out, is going to say, hey, we've had great feedback, blah, blah, blah. Sure, that's great. But I will let the research kind of dictate whether or not that's true. So they're the first thing on Google, which is cool. So I'll check out their website. And they're also on LinkedIn. So I'll be able to check out their company more so on that. And I'll just kind of creep around the internet and see what I can find. Maybe I'll download the app. I'll check out the website and see how it works, what differentiates itself. Because again, it goes back to, am I comfortable selling this to my audience? What actually makes it stand out from the rest of the apps, right? Like I could probably partner with DraftKings or FanDuel or something like that. Not a partnership, but I can get an affiliate code or something like that and just pitch that to everyone. And everyone knows those companies. But what about this new company sets it apart? Like how do I pitch this to my audience so that I'm actually giving them value in a sense, you know? So I'm gonna do that right now. Out here doing work. I love to do my work outside now that it's getting nice out. Sorry if I'm glistening. I put some tanning lotion on. Yeah, try to get out and do my work out here whenever I can. So I'll just set up, post up there, put my work laptop up here or on the table. Wherever the sun is, I'll go. It's like the name of a fucking corny song. Wherever the sun is, I'll go. It's like 85 degrees out here today. It's like 3 o'clock and my draft guide launches in less than 4 weeks, sorry. So I have like 3.5 weeks to get everything done. I know it sounds like a long time, but for me, it's kind of making me anxious and giving me anxiety because there's a lot of work to be done. There's probably at least, I banged out one big article today that was like 4,000 words, but there's probably 3 more articles like that that will take me like each a day to finish. That knocks out like a day a piece for those, and then I'm obviously gonna have to figure out, I'm gonna have to like put it together. Like that's just the raw, like me actually doing the research and writing the article in Microsoft Word, and I'm gonna have to transform it into a way that's aesthetic into the actual magazine.
I'm also gonna have to figure out a way to give access to everyone, because I don't know, there's just a lot of behind the scenes stuff I have to figure out, so I'm getting like a little anxious, and I know I need to start knocking all this shit out, because along with the draft guide, of course, I'm always putting out, I have 5 videos a week I'm doing, so I have the Monday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday vlog, Sunday live stream, and then of course my marketing work as well, which I have to keep up on, so it's just a lot happening right now, a lot's going on with my work stuff. It's all good problems to have, I just have to kind of take a step back and realize that I'm creating something very cool, and you know, don't stress about it. I'm actually going to check how many pre-orders we have right now. As of Thursday at 3-ish p.m. I'm gonna go to the gym a little while and then play basketball afterwards. Keep your head still. 1206 minus 1168. So that's 30, 40. Ooh, 30. Oh, word. So we're at 98 pre-orders. 2 away from 100 pre-orders. That's fucking crazy. 100 people are pre-ordering this magazine I'm putting together. And I'm wondering, like, I don't know. I don't know what to reasonably project sales to be at this point. I don't know if the mid to end of August, I'm gonna see like a fucking huge fluctuation of people buying my thing. Like, for all I know, it could start going like 5 to 10 copies at a time. Right now, it's probably coming in like maybe on average, like 1 order a day or so. As I keep plugging into my videos, I don't plug it into all my videos, but as I do, that will keep increasing. So, I mean, I think the sales could be really good. It could be, could surprise how many I end up selling, so.
All right, Playboys, this is the end of the vlog. So, if you enjoyed, thumb it up. About to get some reading in. As I sit in my driveway, this is what I was talking about earlier. Like, I just sit here, usually with my shirt off. I feel like being clothed today. Anyways, yeah, give it that thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. And as always, we'll see y'all next Saturday.